Hi, and welcome to the AYTM.com Conditional and Masking Logic tutorial video. Today, I will teach you how to take advantage of more advanced survey programming techniques without writing a single line of code. You'll learn how to use conditional and masking logic syntax and will become a Jedi of sequential monadic survey structure with random up and down navigation using custom skip rules. Conditional logic is an extension of the simple skip logic that we covered in the survey editor overview video. It goes beyond navigation within the survey and allows hiding or showing survey elements based on each respondent's prior selected or viewed answers. It doesn't have UI controls. Just add conditional logic rules and square brackets directly into the survey fields. Character counts won't be reduced by the formulas. Please note that in order to use this feature, you will have to turn it on for a fee on the survey level or be on a paid subscription plan that covers it. Please also test your survey thoroughly and use at your own risk, as it's intended for experienced users. Just like piping rules, an entire conditional logic rule must be surrounded with square brackets. Conditional logic formulas are not cap sensitive. The following four cases are currently supported: skip to, mask by, show if, hide if. Let's start with the simplest, skip logic. Skip logic extends the functionality, available through direct and random skip logic features, that I covered in a separate tutorial video. If all you need is to skip respondents from one question to another based on their answer, or set up a simple monadic survey structure, you may get away without using conditional logic. Skip to logic has a few more advanced options. It also controls navigation from a given question, a single choice answer, or a not applicable answer on a multiple choice question. It's available in two modes, with a condition, or a series of conditions, or without. If you type skip to Q16, this takes the respondent to one destination without a condition, same as the rabbit icon here in the user interface, or UI. If this rule is entered into a question field, it will be executed when the respondent exits the question. If it's entered into an answer field, the jump will be made only if the respondent selected that answer choice and clicked Next. If you type skip to Q16 or Q17 or Q18, this takes each respondent to one of a few listed destinations without a condition, same as the die icon in the UI. If you type skip to Q16 or Q17 or Q18 if Q1A1, this takes each respondent to one of several destinations with the condition that the first answer choice on Q1 must have been selected as well. Please note that a condition, everything after if, is applied to all listed destinations. Say I asked respondents if they eat desserts in the first question. Those who selected yes, answer 1, I would want to show a random image of the 3 desserts I've uploaded. Those who said no would skip this section altogether. As you can see here, skip logic can be combined with the simple direct or random skip settings, the rabbit and die icons. If there is a conflict, conditional logic will override the conflicting rabbit and die settings. Sometimes you will need to set 2 different skip conditions for the same field. In this example, respondents who said that they were interested in dessert will be skipped to one of the dessert images. Those who said no will skip right over the series to the 6th question. Please don't forget to set direct skips for every question within each of your potential destinations, if you want to set up a monadic survey structure. Otherwise, respondents will follow the default flow of the survey and may be exposed to more than one stimulus. What if you need respondents to see a series of questions, but each series must appear in random order? Well, it can be done with the same skip to rule, repeated at the last question of each series. Say I want to ask 2 questions about each of my 3 desserts. First, I enter the splitting skip rule in the question above the first series here. Then I add the same rule to the question fields of Q3, Q5, and Q7. Respondents will be randomly skipping up or down, but the platform will make sure that nobody is exposed to the same question more than once, guaranteeing that once they have seen all 3 series, they'll continue with the organic flow of the survey. Let's take a look at the preview. Please note that conditional logic has to be tested in the respondent's view mode. If you have additional requirements, for example, you have 20 series of questions and each must appear randomly, but no more than 5 series can be presented to each respondent, you would have to reach out to us and order custom logic programming. We'll be happy to set it up for you on the back end. Let's now take a look at masking logic. As you may have guessed from the name, masking logic allows you to mask one question based on answers given to an earlier question in the survey. By entering mask by Q1 directly into the second question field, you are telling the platform to show respondents only the answers in the second question that they selected in the first question. Let's look at this example. Question 6 lists 5 restaurants as multiple choices, or checkboxes. Respondents are asked to select only restaurants they are aware of. Q7 is a ranking question. It contains the code mask by Q6 in the question field and has all 5 corresponding answer options. By the time a respondent arrives at Q7, they'll see only those restaurants they selected in Q6. Since masking magic is governed by the positions of answer choices rather than the actual text within them, you can adjust the phrasing of the fields according to your needs. For example, if the first question contains a list of physical activities to select among, say, running, swimming, and hiking, the masked question may be asking about the frequency of each selected activity. For example, how often do you run, swim, and hike? Make sure to keep the corresponding items at the same positions in each question for mapping to work properly. Don't worry if the masked by list contains other please specify or none of the above answer options that won't have corresponding answer choices on the masked question. They'll simply be ignored. You can use the following question types as the source for masking logic. Checkboxes, we will mask by all checked items. Progressive matrix, we will mask by all sub-questions, row or columns, that received at least one checkbox. And the following question types can be used as masking logic destinations. Radio buttons, checkboxes where answers will be masked, as well as matrices, including sliders, smileys, stars, reorder, side-by-side, distribute, and progressive matrix questions, where sub-questions will be masked. Many questions make little sense if they contain only one answer option. For example, how silly is it to ask which of the following options do you prefer if the only answer choice that came out of the masking exercise is McDonald's? To prevent it from happening if a respondent only selected one option on the masked by question, you can set the minimum number of checkboxes required for this question to 2. Sometimes, however, you don't want to do it, especially when there is only one true and relevant answer. In such cases, you will want to use hide-if logic. Adding the second rule will, in this case, tell the platform to hide all of Q7 if Q6 collected fewer than 2 responses. And yes, you guessed it right. R stands for response. Which brings us to hide-if, show-if rules. As you just saw, conditional logic starts with this type of rule, hide if, show if, and then continues with a condition, a description of given answers or their combination that should trigger the rule. You can express a variety of conditions. Let me give you a few examples. PQ1A1 is a condition that will trigger an event if the first answer in the first pre-qualification question was selected. Q1 is a condition that will trigger an event if a question was shown to a respondent. Q4A5 is simply if answer 5 on question 4 was selected. Q2SQ1 describes a situation when sub-question 1 on question 2 was shown to the respondent. Q3SQ1A1 means answer 1 in sub-question 1 on question 3 was selected. And here are some slightly more advanced cases, in case your brain isn't hurting already. Q6SQ1P1. Letter P stands for position. This particular condition means subquestion 1 was dragged to the top position by the respondent on question 6, which is a ranking question. Q7SQ1R50 to 100 is if subquestion 1 received between 50 and 100 points on question 7, which is a distribution question. Q8R > or = 2. If 2 or more answers or checkboxes were selected on question 8. Q8R > 2. If more than 2 answers or checkboxes were selected on question 8. Q8R > 2. If fewer than 2 answers or checkboxes were selected on question 8. Q8R > or = 2. If 2 or fewer answers, checkboxes, were selected on question 8. Furthermore, you can add several conditions in one rule by stringing them together with simple prepositions. Show if Q1A1 or Q1A2. Show if one condition is satisfied or another condition is satisfied. In this case, answer 1 or answer 2 was selected in the first question. Show if Q1A1 and Q1A2. Show if one condition is satisfied and another condition is satisfied. In this case, answer 1 and answer 2 were selected in the first question. You can express a negative condition. Sometimes it's much faster than listing all positive conditions with the reversed ShowHide rule. Show if Q1A1 and not Q1A2 means show if one condition is satisfied and another negative condition is satisfied. Here, answer 1 was selected in the first question, but answer 2 was not. Finally, you can use regular parentheses to group conditions together. Show if not Q1A1 and Q1A2. The phrase in the parentheses is describing a situation when both first and second answers on Q1 were selected. Because there is not before the condition, the entire condition must be false. If it's false, the field will be shown. It can be false in a few situations, by the way, like if both answers were not selected, or if only one of them was. Please don't confuse that with this example. Show if not Q1A1 and not Q1A2. See the missing parentheses? Leaving them out means that the platform will show the field only if neither the first nor the second answer on Q1 were selected. By the way, unlike skip to rules, all show if, hide if, and mask if rules starting with the same command must be formulated together within a field. Instead of typing show if not Q1A1, show if not Q1A2, you want to type show if not Q1A1 and not Q1A2. Otherwise, both rules may be ignored. To make it even more flexible, we allow several conditions, isolated in parentheses, to be strung together with or and operators. Here we've entered show if not Q1A1 and Q1A2, or not Q1A3 and not Q1A4. Hold on to your hats, this one's a doozy. This will tell the platform to show the field if neither the first and second answers were selected, or perhaps only one of the answers on the first question were selected, or if neither third nor fourth answers were selected. I hope I didn't lose you on that last one. If it gets overwhelming, please reach out to us. Upon your approval of the cost, we'll be more than happy to take on the heavy lifting of your survey programming, allowing you to save time and meet your deadlines. That's it for now. Thanks again for watching, and feel free to ping us with questions or to set up a personal demo.